Eric Segal. Eric Segal was an American writer and an educator. He is best known for, he was graduate from Harvard. He was the first person in Harvard history to be selected as both Latin salutary orator and class poet. So Harvard for all is, they know, one of the best colleges in the world, or so it is said. Okay. When he earned his PhD in 1964, he was already a faculty at Yale, teaching classic and comparative literature. He continued as a professor in Princeton, and he has got a number of degrees, number of, you know, things, points, write-ups to his name. One of, and he wrote commentaries on Greek and Latin books and novels. Not only did he write in Greek and Latin novels, he also wrote in the, you know, in for common man, his book Love Story is till today one of the most famous novels. One of the there was a movie made on that. Then he has Oliver's Stories, The Class, Doctors, Acts of Faith, Prizes. Each book a masterpiece in its own. And they have very, very different stories, endings from the others. So strategy is a key point with the Nakshatra of Jyestha. Apart from being extremely athletic, apart from having great power, being strategic. And Eric Segal, most don't know, ran 40 marathons also in those days. So he was an unsung athlete also. Okay. He has Rahu in the third house. Again, Rahu in the third house of writing. So he wrote differently. He thought out of box. He was different in his approach towards. And third house is also oration. So he had great oratory powers. Third house is also writing. Very different form of writing. Third house is also athletics. Third house is also courage and power. There's many things about his life that you can read on later, okay? And but for starters, he was a very strategic and a very athletic personality, okay? So we can take up Indra and Vritasura's story as one of the concluding stories. Indra had many brothers. Indra is one of the Aditya. There are 12 Adityas. I think I have said that in many of my videos earlier also. There are 12 Adityas, and one of them, 12 Adityas, each Aditya ruling one of the 12 signs also. They move into the 12 signs. Aditya means of Aditi, born of Aditi. And they are the 12 sons of Aditi, as in S-O-N-S. And they're also the 12 sons who rule over the 12 signs of the zodiac. Okay, and each Aditya has his own serpents, has his own, what else should I say? They have their own serpents, they have their own rishis, they have their own apsaras, own set of horses following them. So it's a very beautiful concept about it. And one of them is Tatsvara or Vishwakarma. So they're brothers in fact. But what Tatsvara has a son from one of the Daitya wives. Okay. So that son, obviously. So if your mother belongs to different caste, that doesn't mean that you're not going to love your mother's family. That son being the loves his mother's family equally well. Now, I did tell you that Indra once made a slight fallacy, if I can say that slight. It shouldn't be called slight, in fact. He was so much indulgent in his own dance and his own drink that when his guru made his presence felt in his pot, he does not acknowledge that presence. And what happens? His guru vanishes, leaving behind and now not to be found anywhere. So guru is also means someone who directs you. who's taller than you in stature and will direct you in more than one ways, okay, in your physical, mental, spiritual, financial, and you know, emotional advent to a different level. When he's left you, they are at sea. And when the word gets around to the Daityas that, you know, that the Dev Guru has left, they become more and more bold. So now they need a they need somebody to help them desperately, the Devtas. So they call on Vrittasur's, they call on Tatsvar's son, who has three head, to come and help them, you know, do the prayers. And when the person, when that young chap is doing it for them, in the side, he is also praying for the Danavas. And the battle is ensuing, so the Danavas are not getting defeated. And finally, Indra realizes that this person, he is praying for us, but at the same time, he is praying for the Danavas also. He gets so angry that without thinking for a cause, that it is his nephew or his brother's child whom, you know, he's doing harm to, he kills, instantly killing that young man. And as a result, Tatsvar or Vishwakarma gets very, very angry, and he makes a demon called Vrittasur. Because he's Vishwakarma, so he gives birth to Vrittasur. Vrittasur is said to be one of the most deadliest of demons because he will simply not die. He creates a mess bigger than what the Daityas are capable of doing to Indra's kingdom. Okay? But Indra does not lose heart. As I was telling you, he's a master strategist. He has the ability to fight it right through and through. So what Indra does is he, you know, then comes in the story of Dadhichi giving up his body, physical body, so that his bones can be to the Ashwini Kumars and everything. But that's another story. But in short, the bones of Dadhichi Rishi is used to make the Vajra. You can see this, you know, you can see this mace. It's made of bones, okay? It's here, it's given the shape of the mace, but it's actually a thunderbolt, and this thunderbolt is used to destroy Vrittasur. So these people will always have a plan B. That brings me back to Winston Churchill here, that these people will always have a plan B. They will never give up. They do not have a giving up attitude in life. They will fight till the very end. This is one stellar quality about the Jyestha Nakshatra, that they will always fight till the very end. And they're highly competitive. They never give up. Third house is also the house of Parakram. Okay? It has to be a retrograde Venus. Third house is the house of Parakram. So third house, Venus actually makes it one of the most significant, you know, places to be in. It's not December 30th, it's November 30th. So it's the third house. So it is the house of Parakram and effort. Okay. And that is one of the reasons why the World War II was saved. You know, the thousands and thousands of people who could have perished even after it had the World War II not stopped when it did, were saved. He was a mastermind strategist, never gave up, went on to save a lot of Europeans. What happened in India and other underdeveloped countries, the UN countries, is a very different thing. But as when we are concentrating on one of the good points, we can always say that this was used. Highly accomplished. Now, another flip side we will cover is, see, another daring and charismatic person, fifth house of charisma, fifth house of attraction, fifth house of, what should I say, flamboyancy, celebrityhood. Christopher Reeves, as I told you in the beginning, we'll see one of the superheroes making their presence felt. He is the first Superman. Superman. Okay? So, Christopher Reeves, he suffered a lot. He had fallen down during a competition. And then on, he had to use a wheelchair because he was on a ventilator for the rest of his life. And he was a pioneer, one of the greatest champions for human embryonic stem cells. Now when you see, it's the Lagna Lord in Jyestha Nakshatra. So he was, you can see his chiseled looks. He was so handsome. Mars, again, it's a beautiful combination of the Lagna Lord and the Fifth Lord. There was no denying his charisma. Had he not had that fatal, accident, he would have gone places as an actor. Even today, Christopher Reeve's name is synonymous with superheroes of yesteryear, that is Superman. So they were daring, very athletic. You know, they always some sort of form of sport or the other, and they take it very personally. Honestly, the Jyeshtha people with planet in Jyeshtha Nakshatra, they take any competition very personally. It is do and then die. It's not about do or die. It's do and then die, or do rather better take the trophy home. So that's it. So again, when I'm talking about competition, Bill Gates is again... For the Indians who've known Nutan, Nutan is the very well-known aunt of Kajol, another Indian actress. And in her days, she appeared for more than 70 Hindi films. She was one of the finest actress, and it is said that she was the only youngest one to receive 5 wins of the Best Actress Award, Filmfare Award. In those days, we just had Filmfare Awards. We didn't have the multiple that we find now today. And she was the one who held it as the youngest for and the maximum 5 Filmfare Awards. And later on, it was her, her niece, Nutan, Kajol, who had won it, those 5 Filmfare Awards. And she was also awarded the Padma Shri. She was, as a child, she was not very well known. She was not very beautiful looking. But as she grew up, she became one of the best actresses of her time. Okay, very accomplished, very, very accomplished. And her son, as we will see, she has got Jupiter, retrograde Jupiter in the 3rd house of Parakram, which is the 7th lord of career. Okay, and the 4th Lord of Masses, sitting in the house of courage, sitting in the house of creativity, sitting in the house of finance. And her son, when we are doing the Jyeshtha Nakshatra, know that the sons of these nakshatras, okay, are also very, of Jyeshtha Nakshatra, are also very well known. The sons of Indra happen to be Raja Bali, who is in Ramayana, we come across Raja Bali, who is killed by Lord Rama, and the other putra or other son of, it's Raja Bali, and the other son is, Arjuna in Mahabharata. Okay, so, they are well known. They are also very well known in their own right. Raja Bali was the King Bali. He was one of the most powerful kings in his times, because he once, under his arm, he tied Ravana on his in his tail, and he roamed the world, the universe, for 6 months. Arjuna, his valor, we all know in Mahabharata. So the sons of people in this nakshatra, who have their children also do very well, I would like to take here the name of Nutan's son. Monish Bell is also a well-known actor in the Indian film industry. Okay, so and then there's a pride before, I've always told you and I make it a point to do it again, there's a pride before fall for people in Jyestha Nakshatra. When they grow too big for their own stature, like had it happened with Indra with Lord Krishna, also the story of Govardhan, well known by most of us here. So this is another story where this happens, where they are put to their place. The example being Lester Bang and many others. So Madonna also has an important planet right there, Saturn, sitting there in Jyestha Nakshatra. When we move on to the symbol of Jyestha, the symbol of Jyestha is, it can be two things together. It's a circular amulet, and it is an umbrella, and it is also has, it's also signifies earrings. That brings me to the story of Mother Aditi's earrings being in the Mahabharata, in the Bhagavad Puran, we know, come across a story where Mother Aditi's earrings are stolen by or forcibly taken by Narakasura, and then Krishna comes to rescue. After Krishna comes to rescue, Krishna gets the earrings, gives it very reverentially back to Mother Aditi, and Satyabhama, who would help Krishna rescue the earrings from Mother Aditi, gets enamored by the Parijata tree and just wants a flower. And Krishna says, you can just take the tree, doesn't matter. And then there ensues a battle again between Krishna and Indra. And obviously, Krishna's won it once, he wins it again. And Indra has to apologize and hand over the Parijata tree to Satyabhama. So the earring also would signify that the protection is there, but know that you should, Kundal, it's also called Kundal in Hindi, in Sanskrit. So it signifies a lot of weight. It signifies a lot of power and position itself. And if there is a malefic sitting in that, in that nakshatra for any of you, you will have perpetual problems with your earrings or, with your hearing also and with power. The protection, the consolidation, so symbolizing power, in the earlier times, it was used as a symbol of power. It was whoever was very reverential, there was an umbrella held over that person. So that is a symbol of power, that is a symbol of protection, cover, guidance, because it also saves us in the times of problems. When it's raining, you would want to have a cover over your head, and that is the cover. It is a protection that it gives you. So you can wear it like a covering, kavach around you. The planet is Mercury. We know Mercury is very intelligent. We know the facilities that if your Mercury is very strong, you will have a very sharp and a very quick and agile mind. But you could also be nervous because Mercury rules over the nervous system. So if your Mercury is not very high, it will rule over your nervous system also. This is a Rakshashgan, meaning there is a very strong will. Please don't take it like it's, at one hand I'm talking about Indra as a Devata and this as a Rakshasa. Rakshasa Gan is, it's kind of a nature. It's a, in Hindi we say it's pravritti, or it's basic intrinsic nature of a person to have a very strong will and break barriers. Indra is an epitome of breaking barriers, where he's always rushed along, fought, where people would Others would not dare, like with Vrittasur. He had a fight. He knew that the weapons, he would have to have it manufactured, would have to get it done, and he knew how to do it. At the same time, he was an ace strategist, as I'm telling you again and again. He knew he could not fight Narakasur. So he pleads Lord Krishna, who has the Sudarshan, the most dangerous weapon in the universe, to fight Narakasur. And to not just fight Narakasur, because he also knew that Lord Krishna was waiting for an opportunity to fight Narakasur, to deliver that 16,000 young princesses from his... So it's all about knowing how to attack, when to attack. It's not just a good general does not mean a person who makes a face on attack. It's very strategic planning, that you cover your enemy in such a way that the enemy is not able to run away, escape from any which ways. That is what Indra is all about. And he imparts this quality very strongly into the Nakshatra of Jyestha, along with many other qualities that he imparts. For us, for those people who would like to, you know, work on the remedies for Indra, because see, you can take up many professions with this. Either ways, you will have the ability, provided that Jyestha falls in a good house for you, to climb a great height in life. That is for sure. If you have key planets, strong planets, like, you know, your fifth lord in the eighth, in the tenth house, or you know, these auspicious planets falling there, then definitely an advent is very good. And you have the makings of detective, leader, occultist, government service, trade, orator. Detective is one very good thing that you can find in Jyestha. We all saw Indra peeping through that, in that picture, at what was going on in the scene below. So air traffic controller, because Indra is also the ruler of the skies, people in telecom industry, athletes, very strongly. So all these things are going. The flip side we've seen. So if you're able to, every deity will impart its good and bad to us. They also give us the ability, because we are humans, we are made of gray, we are shades of gray. So they give us an ability to choose and how to make, you know, that is what karma is all about. On what level we make our planets resonate. It takes a lot of push to move out from the mundane to a spiritual level, but it's possible. That is what karma is all about, acting and not reacting. And Indra also gives us the opportunity. Jyestha also gives us the opportunity. For all of us, here, whichever house Jupiter falls for us, that is the house that is getting triggered, along with Scorpio and Jyestha Nakshatra in particular. So it's an opportunate moment to make those houses owned by Jupiter in our chart very right at the moment, to the help of a preceptor, through the help of our inner voice, inner calling, and, you know, improve on our karma. Because again, it's the eighth house of the natural zodiac, which gives us the power of penance and the power of solitude and the power of research and sadhana also. So it's not just the negatives that is associated with it. Putting discipline over the self, these are the things that can be done, you know, giving assistance to others, doing responsible act, acting with restraint, monitoring situations, administrative abilities, all these will work into our favor. The Beej Mantra, and you know, Bhavaji, on your channel, I've always told people not to do Beej Mantra. I do it even in my own Nakshatra classes or any other class. I do tell people not to do Beej Mantra without proper guidance of a guru. There's a Gayatri Mantra involved, and I would personally, you know, love it if people could do the shlokas of the Vishnu Sahasrana. It's much better. It's much more... it resonates to Lord Vishnu also, so he will help you cross along with Indra. And the remedial measures are more of a, on a Tuesday, you could give green grains. Or on a Wednesday, you could give pomegranate seeds to a young boy. You could feed on a Wednesday, you could feed a young boy. Things like that, you will be able to come across as a remedial measure. The goddess is Purnadevi, goddess that she and the god here for the temple. You can, you know, you can see the temple there. You can contact the temple in Tanjore district, the Nakshatra temple, and they will guide you as to what can be done to satisfy or to pacify your Jyestha Nakshatra. So this brings us to the end of the Jyestha Nakshatra for us.
Amazing, wonderful it is. So I think people can use it to check, as you said at the end, you know, which houses Jupiter is ruling in your chart, not where it is placed in your chart, but where, which houses is it ruling. All right. So for those who are beginners, the sign 9 and 12 is ruled by Jupiter. And to end this, one last thing I would like to share, which I heard long back about Indra. This is maybe around 7-8 years back. So I was attending a satsang program where one of my friends, my godbrothers, he was asking to one of my gurus that if you read the Srimad Bhagavatam or Ramayana or Mahabharata, these scriptures, then you will always find that 99.999999 cases, not 100 exactly, almost 100, but 99.99. If there is a demon or a asur or a rakshas or a daitya who does anything nonsense, so what Lord Vishnu does, he will simply appear, he will take the Sudarshan Chakra, he will rip his head off. 99%, except for Maharaj Bali and except for Prahlad, except for these two. Of course, these two are one of the 12 Mahajans, of course. But we see time and again that Indra is doing so many things sometimes. But yes. Why there is no incense? Now, as you said, Krishna had humiliated Indra, you know, by showing his position during the Govardhan Lila and as for the Parijat also. But there is no instance in the entire scriptures where they say that Vishnu was about to kill Indra, na? So why is it? It might seem like it's something very partial, right?
They're also brothers.
Yeah, so then my guru, he answered that Indra, although he does many wrong things at times, which he pays also, as we had seen, you know, like he has this thousand. but inherently he is a very good person. He is one who upholds, you know, the tradition of the scriptures. Yes, and he also supports, you know, good activities in general. So that is why Lord Vishnu knows that he can become good and he can behave good. That potential is there.
Yeah. Exactly, and moreover, as I told you earlier on,
we can extrapolate these two planets which are in Jyestha also. Like, yes. Recently, I was in Berlin, then I was with one person, then he was telling me that Jyestha Nakshatra has a very bad reputation in the astrology market.
I did not by any chance give it a very bad reputation,
No. That's what I'm saying. That people who see videos on Jyestha, there are many videos in YouTube, or there is a, as in Hindi they say, there's a word, Bhranti. Bhranti means it's like, you know,
it's an illusion about Jyestha.
Appears like that. So this answer which my Guru Maharaj once gave, that he's inherently a very good person. Sometimes he does some mischief. So we should also understand. So suppose now you have Moon in Jyestha, or suppose you have Venus in Jyestha, or Sun, or whichever planet. It doesn't mean that you will run into a scandal about related to that planet. It doesn't mean that. It means that although you may be in a very good stature, as you rightly showed in different examples, if you misuse your power, if you denigrate others, especially your gurus, primarily, and now more because Jupiter is itself transiting, you know, then there will be a fall down. So The free will is always there, so that's how I would like to end this session. You know that if you
Babaji, I can I just add one more thing to it? See, when a planet is in Jyestha, they will have the best capacity possible. But as you said, you need to rub it out. So what Krishna has done or any other teacher has done is given the best student a slap on the knuckle and said, it's high time you came back to your goodness. You know, it's like the student who's always standing first, he's now loitering around and he's wasting his time. So they gave him a knuckle and said, come back to shape now.
And
that's it.
Another thing I would like to say to people here, that recently we had Saturn transiting Jyestha. One day very soon, you know, the nodes will also transit, you know, Ketu will transit. But now Jupiter is transiting, and these four planets, Rahu, Ketu, Jupiter, Saturn, are very slow moving planets. So their transits affect us. So what I would like to say is that in this year, 2019, because Jupiter is transiting in Jyestha, and because it's a Gandanta zone, you know, the end degrees, and especially in April, it is March and it is getting retrograde, and April again it is entering back. So the month of April, and to be precise, the entire year, this Gandanta zone will be active to a big, large extent. So there will be many things which you will have to throw out, which you will realize maybe by next year beginning, that it was very nice that I let those
next
things
year
go.
April, you know, next year, not this year, around December, you would also, November,
exactly.
December, you
by
would,
November, it's transiting to Mula finally. So you will come to know about that. Yes, these things are finally not, you know, I cannot be the Indra
required in my life.
Yeah. So then that feeling you will get. So there might be some challenges which you face, and those challenges you might think that you are going to fight, and you fight till the end. But in Srimad Bhagavatam, I forgot which canto this story is, the Vritrasur pastime. There's a very interesting statement there. It is said that Vritrasur, who he is actually, people just say Vritrasur is demon, you know, blah, 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 he's this person. But actually, he's Chitra Ketu Maharaj, you know.
Yes.
He was so exalted that he had seen Lord Vishnu once. And he just made a joke to Lord Shiva once, you know, that, oh, Lord Shiva, what is this funny thing which you are doing? You know, you are giving knowledge on renunciation and sannyas, but your wife, Rama Devi, Parvati, is sitting on your lap. So how dare, only you can do this. So indirectly, he was telling Lord Shiva how great you are, that in this universe, there's only one person, you know, who can do that, having your wife on your lap and you are speaking on how to be detached. You know, no ordinary person can do that. And then Lord Shiva is also so great. He says that, oh, you are telling about me. What are you doing? You know, and then Lord Shiva says, I have only one beautiful woman on my lap, but you are surrounded by 50 or more, you know, so many beautiful heavenly there, you know, he was he was more elevated than the devatas also, you know. So in the company of all these ladies, you know, and generally they say that when we are in the company of the opposite sex, you know, God is the last thing that we remember. So he said that you are also, you know, discussing about spiritual topics in this airplane, going from different places to places. So you are also no less, you know, I have only one, you have so many. So you are also no less. But Parvati, she could not understand this, because she's a very chaste lady, and a chaste lady cannot, you know, tolerate if somebody insults her husband. She said, oh, Chitra Ketu, how dare you say like this about my husband? Who the hell are you? You know, you are just a petty king of this world, you know, and where Lord Shiva is. So I curse you that you become a demon. And in that part, that famous, very, very, very famous shloka comes, you know. Narayana para sarve na kutaschana vibhyati. That sloka is there. And Bhagavatam says that Chitra Ketu Maharaj was so powerful that he could have cancelled the curse which Mother Parvati gave, and he could have counter-cursed her, that, oh, you give me a curse, now I give you a curse. And it would and there was no way that Parvati could have revoked that curse. But Chitra Ketu Maharaj did not do that. He just folded his hands and he said, Oh, that is what you want. Actually, that's not what you want. That's what Lord Vishnu wants. That's what Narayan wants. So if he wants that I become a demon, then so be it. You know, and then Lord Shiva speaks this verse, that one who is surrendered to Lord Narayan, Swarga Apavarga Naraka Api Tulyarthi Darshina, means Swarga and Narak, heaven and hell is same for him. Yeah, everything is same. So that's the greatness of Chitraketu. And later on he becomes Vritrasura. And the final lesson is that when Indra, when Indra is killing Vritrasura with this thunderbolt, the Vajra, which was made by Dadichi's backbone, then what happens was Vritrasura, he's telling to Indra, and these are directly there in pages of Srimad Bhagavatam. I'm not quoting it from myself.
Yes.
Why are you worrying so much? Throw it. Phek usko. And because he wants to die as soon as possible, and he wants to go back to Vaikuntha because he's 24 hours remembering Lord Vishnu. Yeah, Vishnu. But when your enemy tells you like this, "Arey kya re phek, maar 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 mujhe maar," then your confidence goes down. Right? You are like, "My God, this will work or not? I mean, how in the universe is he so confident?" And then Indra, he becomes small than the size of atom or molecule. And then he goes inside and he cuts his entire body. He needs, I guess, 1 year or some say 365 years to cut his entire body. And then at the end, what happens? Vritrasura gets moksha. He is delivered. He goes back to the spiritual world. But Indra stays back in this material world. He's like, "I will enjoy the heavens. Then I will take another birth."
Yes.
So there's a very beautiful lesson here that sometimes with Jyestha, you can have this tendency that you have fought so much and you think you have won the battle, but then at the end you will understand that it was not worth it, fighting for all. On the opposite side, you may think that, I lost this battle, like Vritrasura lost. And after losing, you might think, actually, I didn't lose, I won it actually.
And yeah, this, that is such a beautiful part.
By the end of November, December, you will come to know more of this. So that's what I wanted to share.
Yes, whether you have been an Indra or Vritrasura.
Yeah, so it's like this, one of my gurus once said, it is better to be Vritrasura than to be Indra, because if you are Indra, then you will stay back. Yeah, but anyways, nonetheless, whatever our dasha is telling, that will ultimately prevail over all of this. But even then, whichever houses Jupiter is ruling, wherever Sag and Pisces is falling, you will get a flavor of this. I mean, that's inevitable. That will happen within the context of the dasha. Dasha is saying great things will happen. Maybe you become a great person. If dasha is saying there is some...
Even where it is sitting, it is activated at the moment. But these two signs will definitely be activated, where you will have to let go. You might have to relinquish your power, and you will have to come back to basics, start from the basics, because Mula is that tapa that you do as a basic. But we will take it up in the section of Mula next time, Bhavaji.
All right.
That moves into Mula.
Yes, yes, yes. Thank you very much. It was wonderful as usual. And yes, you have a great channel and you also do consultations. So many of the people, maybe they are already your subscribers, but if somebody has not subscribed, then I will pin the channel in the description. You can go and subscribe. Okay. So next, maybe we do Mula Nakshatra.
Definitely. We'll meet on Mula Nakshatra before quite a period elapses. Okay. Well then, thank you very much, Babaji, for having me on board.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you for coming. See you then.
Bye.